Massive Halo Infinite campaign news drop just happened today, guys. We got some brand new campaign gameplay and a bunch of extra great good stuff. And in this video, I compile all the information that just dropped today in one video. So if you want to know everything, stay tuned throughout the whole video to understand all the details. Guys, I am currently lost in the sauce. I'm lost in the details because all this Halo Infinite campaign gameplay is just absolutely incredible. So what I'm gonna do in this video is give you an overall arcing of all the news that just dropped today from multiple sources. And then in a second video, we're gonna break down these videos that were released to finer details to reveal what is actually going on with the gameplay in these videos. But this one's like the TLDR of everything that just dropped. So if you guys like these news and informational videos, make sure you tap that like button. Let me know you wanna see some more content like this. If you wanna stay updated with everything going on with Halo as it wrap up to the release of Halo Infinite, which is less than a month, make sure to tap subscribe. So let's get right into the content here. Well, to start off, IGN and Game Informer had some exclusive gameplay here, guys. So let's check out what IGN had to say about the first 4 hours of Halo Infinite's campaign experience. First thing off the bat that they mention is the emphasis on characters. And it seems like that's gonna be a really great thing to see, because obviously with Halo 4 and Halo 5, that wasn't really that delve deep very much into the characters, but it looks like in Halo Infinite, you're gonna have some really strong characters to attach to in this game here, guys. They also mentioned that they did not see any Flood, but it was alluded to. There were no Prometheans either, at least within the first 4 hours that they played on Halo Infinite. And so I'm kind of shocked to not hear anything about the Flood, but of course this might be something you might see towards the end or something like that. Adding in the Flood along with all these other enemies and new baddies that you have to fight against would be a bit much, so I understand that, and also the lack of Prometheans is kind of interesting as well, but we just have to continue on and see what happens the rest of the game though, obviously. They do talk about Cortana as well, but they said that she's a bit more of a mystery and takes more of a backseat, but still like involved in the story in some capacity, but not really like the main villain or anything. I think they're leaving it up to like Escherim and the Banished, which I think is a better move. Probably allude to probably more like sequels and future DLC when it comes to Cortana's main involvement when it comes to being in Zeta Halo and Halo Infinite as a whole. Though they do mention that there's going to be some serious Chief Cortana feels being hit as well in this. I mean, there's one scene that like really hits home.
She's not the driver, but a way to level the playing field.
What do I call her?
Ask her. She named herself.
Hello, Master Chief. I'm Cortana.
So yeah, the feels, dude, like that's gonna be happening quite a bit, I'm sure, within this game. She probably has some flashbacks, like the good old memories of Cortana, which is just like hitting you right in the feels for sure right there. They also talk about how Zeta Halo's open world like gameplay is going to be. It's not gonna be a true open world. The way they said it's gonna be kind of broken up is that Zeta Halo has these islands that you'll be able to fight through, play through, unlock, and get, you know, a better footing for the UNSC right then and there. And then what's gonna happen is that you are able to unlock the next section through these bridges, but then there's gonna be these forward operating bases that you need to take control of as well, which we covered previously on the channel as well. This is where they'll act as like fast travel locations and spawn point locations where you can like call in like a wasp or vehicles or new weapons and loadouts and things like that as well. The IGN reviewer does mention that the world of Zeta Halo doesn't seem like as large as like Assassin's Creed or something like that, but of course Assassin's Creed recently is getting a lot of criticism for being a bloated game, so that could be actually a good thing, but we'll just have to see what happens with that. They do mention about Valor. This is the first time we've actually heard about Valor within Halo Infinite, and saying that it's kind of like a point-based tracker of how much ground you've covered and taken over for the UNSC. And the more Valor that you have, the more goodies that you can call in at a forward operating base. So it sounds like something that's not gonna be like necessary for you to do, but if you just want to make the gameplay experience a little bit easier for you and play around with a little bit more of the tools and sandbox of Halo Infinite, that option is there for you as well. And this was kind of expected. They said that the weapon also is very crucial to the gameplay experience as well, where she'll be giving you different kind of callouts of different objectives and things you can do out in the world as well. So it's not gonna be just like Marines and this person, that person, that person, Chief doing like a series of different fetch stories like you see oftentimes with open world kind of games. This is much more concise and scripted and a little bit more focused kind of gameplay experience. And so this is what we're gonna be kind of experiencing a lot more with Halo Infinite, they do mention about high value targets, which we've seen previously within the map reveal and stuff like that. Apparently high value targets are going to have signature special weapons that once you take them over, you can call in those weapons at forward operating bases. We do know that Halo Infinite will feature various weapon variants as well. So I think this might be the chance to add in those weapon variants into Halo Infinite's gameplay. And so it'd be an awesome chance to get around and play with more awesome little sandbox goodies. What you're seeing right here is the scanner ability. This is like a way for you to kind of find objectives and collectibles within the world of Zeta Halo as well. I actually like this a lot more than just like having like a little HUD icon that pops up on your screen. Have it be more manually controlled by the player. I think this is really great, and it also helps provide a little bit more of a immersive kind of environment as well, rather than having like a big obvious glowy button that you need to press kind of thing. So I think it's a great job by 343 to make sure to avoid any kind of like very gameplay like or video game like elements, have a much more immersive things. So I'm all for that. It seems like kind of like the surface level open worldy kind of stuff. It's more just kind of like doing the side missions, gaining valor, more experience, more equipment and things like that. Where if you go into these main story beats where you really go into these interiors of Zeta Halo, these more like Forerunner like biomes and things like that. You do know that boss battles are going to be a thing as well within Halo Infinite, and you get a nice little gameplay snippet of the battle against Tremonius here, which we had in the gameplay overview as well. And you can kind of see with the gameplay here that like the traditional Halo experience of damage dealing kind of still fits in with these characters. She's dealing damage like this more physical bullet projectile kind of stuff, but then when you switch over the plasma, it rips off the shields pretty easily. So I think those traditional Halo mechanics are still going to be there, but I think just be more emphasized and something that you have to really utilize when taking on these bosses. And she mentions while she's playing on heroic difficulty, kind of going through it pretty easily, but then the boss battle really was a challenge. So that's really great to see. Halo's always had difficulty with doing boss battles within the game, and so hopefully this time around it will be a little bit, you know, more engaging, a little bit more fun to play. We also had some gameplay from Game Informer. They had like just raw gameplay that they captured from the campaign here, showcasing what it's going to be playing like. We actually remember this segment from a previous blog update as well. So we actually get to see what the gameplay actually is going to be like. And you can just see, dude, like the environments and just look absolutely incredible. Just looks and feels like traditional, classic, amazing Halo experience. Like I just need, when I was watching these gameplays, I'm like, guys, I just need to jump into this world. It just looks so great. I cannot wait to jump in and play this. We actually got the chance to see a little bit of one of the main banish bases as well, a little bit of gameplay involved with that. And this section just looked super fun to play. I mean, come on, like you're in this crazy banished environment with all these berserker brutes that jump down and just try to smack you around and stuff like that. Like, just a variation of the gameplay right there just looks so great. And you get to save these Marines. Like, you just feel like a freaking hero, man. And that's something that Halo's really been missing out a lot on. And I'm glad to see that it's making a return within Halo Infinite. We also got to see the Stalker rifle in action, which I believe is the first time we've actually got a chance to see it, and a very interesting gameplay mechanic with it. Now, I think the Stalker rifle is the reason why we do not have the DMR right now in the game, because I think it kind of fits that role even better, truly, because it seems like it's a rapid fire, kind of like long distance actual DMR kind of weapon, rather than like a BR replacement like the DMR traditionally was within Halo. This actually is like a long range, semi-automatic, high damage kind of weapon with like a low magazine, which that's how I imagine DMRs, which I think that's kind of how they've been in other kind of shooters out there. Glad to see that Halo Infinite's kind of embracing that a little bit more. That's something that's actually been missing within the Halo sandbox, well, throughout its entirety. So I'm glad to see they make that distinction. Will we see the DMR come back? I don't know, probably, but you know, no guarantees on that. This is actually really cool to see that how there's different fusion coils that you can utilize. That one actually shocked the brute, rather than ones we've seen with explosions and things like that. So there's gonna be a different reason why to pick up and interact with different types of fusion coils, which is super cool to see as well. I feel like I'm a bit lost in the sauce right now because there's so much details to go over in this. So this is kind of more just like the overarching need to know kind of things that were released today, but we will go into further details as of our following blog updates when it comes to IGN and Game Informer as well. I need to read through those and give you guys all the good information, which we'll be releasing later on this channel. If you're new to the channel or missing any content from me recently, check out this playlist right here. I got a link to all my Halo Infinite news and informational videos. Thanks so much for watching. Greatly appreciate it. I'll catch you on the next one. Peace out.